directly dispute that. And they're giving you their opinion of overtraining. I stand behind my original statement. Overtraining is a myth and a fallacy. Okay, why do you say that, CT? I brought up an example of gymnasts and how they do the same routine over and over again, millions and millions of times, to perfect their craft of what they do, of trying to get to the Olympic Games, whatever their ultimate goal may be. And one of these smart MC squared motherfuckers said, okay, but that's body weight. That's not lifting weight. They're using their own body weight. So that doesn't work, CT. I said, okay. I am a throwback. In my era, there was gentlemen like Tom Platt, known for having the greatest legs of all time in bodybuilding. Also known for squatting for 3-4 hours at a session. By many standards, back in the day even, Tom Platt, they would say that Tom Platt was overtrained. But his results, friends, motherfuckers, and motherfuckies are undeniable. Greatest pair of legs in bodybuilding history. Doing what many of you refer to as overtraining. Overtraining is individualized. What may be overtraining for one man is nothing but a regular workout for another. Overtraining cannot be generalized. Overtraining is individualized to you. What you may call overtraining might be my warm-up. Understand? I'm a veteran. United States Army. Proud veteran United States Army. I go to veterans hospital a monthly basis, and I talk to many veterans from World War II, Korean, Vietnam. And with now almost down to the last man, each one will tell me that the best shape they were ever in their whole life was during basic training. In basic training, you are forced to push your body past previously expected limitations. When you thought you could not, what you thought you could not do, your drill instructor, drill sergeant, made you do. He gave you no choice, and therefore your body adapted to the regimen, the strenuous regimen dictated to you by that drill instructor, because he gave you no fucking choice. He dared you, he made you push. And some of you are scared to put that type of dictation upon yourself. You can't do it. So you'll say that it's overtraining because you are afraid to push yourself that far. You will be amazed at what the human body can do. For example, a lot of you say what they do is overtraining, because it's something that you would never attempt to do. Some of the best conditioned athletes in the world, you say they're overtraining, but overtraining is individualized. To them, it's just a walk in the park. To you, it's overtraining. I do 100, 200 reps, 300 reps. I don't advocate that you do. All I ask is that you give it a try before you say CT is full of shit and he doesn't know what he's talking about. All I have is 6 world titles. All I can tell you is what I've done, what I put into action in real life situations. Not what I think about. Not what I theorize about, not what I talk shit about. It's what I have done. What have these so-called experts in this still done? What have you done? What gives you the right to say what is good and what is bad and what works and what doesn't work? What have you put into application? In most cases, not a goddamn thing. Slapping gum don't mean shit. What have you done, motherfucker? Besides talk shit. Tell Tom Fast, overtraining don't work. Tell this little measly 32-year experience, 22 in darn, that overtraining don't work. Flex your bicep. What have you done? Show me that your training method works. Show me, where is the evidence? Where is the proof that what you're saying works? I'm not calling your name, but you know who the fuck you are. Overtraining my ass.
Breathe.